Georgia, ride me up and all about you. In my arms, I'll let me hold you. I'll never let you go again like I did.
Hi guys, so good evening. Welcome back to my magical world. I am Frostbite. And hello guys, if you are new here, well, welcome. So currently at 6:50 in the evening, currently at 6:50 in the evening, and to continue, we're still finishing that book, that never ending book. You know the drill, so I don't have like to tell you, because you guys have been here with me such a long time, and stay there guys, stay with me, okay? So our topic for today, by the way, hello to my friends that are, you know, that are watching. So our title for tonight, for this one, this particular video, is to compare is never fair. So it's a bit long, so stay with me, and yeah, you just sit there, I mean, just do your thing while listening. You don't need like to watch this, you can just hear me out, because it's like a storytelling, guys. So wait, now I'm gonna zoom it, okay? So never measure your success by what others have or haven't done. It's never fair to compare. So people are either a voice or an echo, a thermometer or a thermostat. I agree with Pat Riley. Don't let people tell you what you want. So Jacqueline Briskin warns, don't take anybody else's definition of success as your own, because we all have. So what this part is just saying is like, we all have a different definition of success. One thing might say that he wants to be a doctor and become a doctor. One wants a happy family. So it's all different, guys. One wants an entire building or a business that he really wants. Different, guys. We all have different goals and dreams, so that's your happiness, right? So I'm just reminding you. So no one can build the personal destiny upon the fate or experience of another person. The old saying is true. You have to do your own growing, no matter how tall your grandfather is. You will find that successful people's main concern is rarely what others are thinking. So however, people would worry less about what others think about them if they only realize how seldom they do. They are usually not thinking about you, but wondering what you are thinking about them. So I believe that God rarely uses a person whose main concern is what? Wait lang, page at the back. Is what others are thinking. Okay, so when you are on your younger years, guys, I'm still young, guys, don't say anything, I'm still young, but when you are like, you know, on your teenage years, you're usually you are such a people pleaser. So no matter what you tell me, you have that, it's embedded to you by peer pressure, society, school, your family, your parents, siblings, cousins, all of that might contribute to why you are one of them. Not one of them, one of the people pleaser. So quote and quote. Hi guys, so I wasn't able to finish the entire our topic, but I'm gonna continue it, okay? Because I'm kind of like finishing something right now and it needs to be done. I'm gonna upload a part 2 for that. I'll see you again, and I'm gonna say the ending, the usual thing that I say, like on the part 2. Okay, so just wait for it and relax, guys. We're going to do it in a more not rushing way. I'm finishing something, so good night for now. Bye-bye. Oh, I used to say.
would